big time.
Well, I guess you would consider this a must-win matchup for William Regal. If he doesn't, he's going to have to dress the way that Burchill wants him to, as a lovely buxom wench.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall, making its way to the ring from Blackpool, England, weighing in at 245 pounds, William Regal.
However, Cole, you have to wonder if Regal were to win this match, how would he have Burchill dress? He'd be like a one of those English butlers. But he went on funky jackets and the velvet tie.
I think he simply wants him to wear that suit from Savile Row that he had there.
Yeah, I get my shoes from Savile Row.
It's Savile Row.
Right.
Regal calls it Sinbad.
Well, he's having a lot of fun, this Burchill. Look at that, he's swinging around.
And now he's signing in St. Thomas in the Virgin Islands, weighing in at 240 pounds, Paul Burchill.
What do you think of this Buccaneer?
I think Burchill could go, no doubt about it. Get past the hole. He's got a bunch of pearls and stuff. He usually throws those things around, and he's yet to give you a pearl necklace. I don't know why, but I like Burchill. I think he's right. Oh, look at that. He's having a lot of fun. He gets to carry a sword, as it pointed out. He gets to swing out. It's his family heritage. He's a descent from Blackbeard, right? It's just one of his great-great-great-great-great-grandfathers.
Well, William Regal wasting a little time, backing Burchill into the corner. There's the reversal by Burchill. Hey, what do you think Regal's going to look like dressed as a buxom wench?
We may not see that. I mean, you know.
Okay, well, if he loses, what do you think he's going
to
look like?
Probably not too attractive. He's not my type.
Deep arm drag.
The next move, I think a guy's going to look like dressed as a wench, a woman, a girl, a buxom one. I don't know.
Buxom.
The buxom one.
Left hands by Burchill, knocking Regal down. And Burchill really looks much more aggressive this week, doesn't he?
You think? He's pounding and grounding now. Regal stomped right on his chest.
This is not what I believe this is probably not what William Regal expected coming into this matchup here tonight.
It's William Regal.
Here's the cover hook of the leg. Kick out at two.
He's a very sophisticated man, is Mr. Regal.
Yeah, but don't let that fool you.
No, he's from England. He's from Blackpool, and he's an aristocrat, for God's sakes. And I know how rough he is and as rugged he is.
He was brought up fighting in the carnivals in his teenage years in the streets of Blackpool.
Now it looks like Burchill could... They're uppercutting the hell out of each other, I'll tell you that.
Well, Burchill's going toe-to-toe, and even better on Regal. Here's the cover, hook of the leg, and a two-count. Regal kicks out. Well, remember, winner of this matchup gets to have their opponent dress however he wants.
Well, I wish I could have a match with you, and then you could just dress in, like, a nice suit, not a cheap one.
Whoa! Oh, wow!
That half-Nelson back suplex there, right on the back of Burchill's head.
Members only.
Yes.
Right, I'm gonna get my stuff. Regal back to his feet as we take another look.
Got a half Nelson in there, folks. Look at that, right on the back of Paul Burchill's head. What a way to knock a man out.
Burchill just slammed to the mat below. William Regal really takes offense to the fact that Burchill is in this pirate persona, so to speak. Burchill at one time was Regal's protege. Regal was really proud of Burchill's advancement here. And World Wrestling Entertainment, he sort of feels embarrassed and humiliated by this. Regal, unbelievably aggressive. Here's the cover, and a kick at it, too.
I think Burchill, I think Regal feels that.
Another cover, and again a kick out. Another cover, and again a kick out.
I think William Regal might feel that Burchill, he's more or less an embarrassment he feels to the country of England and stuff. They're both Englishmen, and I don't think there's anything wrong with Paul Burchill going through this.
Oh, my God. Vicious, violent William Regal.
I don't think there's anything wrong.
Teaching a lesson.
Burchill going back to his heritage of piratism. You know, the pirate.
Piratism?
I don't know what they call it, Paul. I don't know. It's not a nationality. Blackbeard was his great-great-great-great-grandfather.
And he was a pirate. It's simple. Pirate.
Okay, it's not a nationality. It's not a religion. I understand. I mean, all right, no problem. I'm not an expert on piratism. But Burchill's an expert on beating the hell out of someone. He seems pretty intense. Watch out!
Oh, Regal with a high knee, catching Burchill. Mentor taking it to protege. Went for the knee lift. Burchill countered. Wow! Here's the cover. Hook of the leg. He got him here. Burchill again defeats William Regal. And Regal's going to have to dress like a witch.
Here is your winner,
won't be seen. Burchill doing for it. I don't know what he called this. Kind of like a walking the plank type of. Like spinning like a back into a suplex or something that's kind of hard to describe. Very unorthodox. But what the hell is Regal going to look like dressed up as a buxom wench?
Well, it's now dawning on Regal that he's going to have to dress up as a lovely buxom wench. Oh, this is going to be great.
Lovely. How lovely is that going to be?
This is going to be great.
You're a weirdo, Paul. You're weirder than Burchill. He's nuts, and so are you. Cover your nipples, Regal, for God's sakes. Next week, he's going to have to cover those things up. I'm going to see in the areolas, I'll tell you that.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next. Oh, look, Regal is just furious. The man who is undefeated in WrestleMania. The man who dumped Mark Kennedy.